Hi, this is Dr. Vijay. Today we are going to study about non-competitive enzyme inhibition. In the non-competitive enzyme inhibition, an inhibitor molecule binds to an enzyme other than substrate binding site or active site. So this binding could be to the pre-enzyme itself, or even this binding of non-competitive inhibitor to the enzyme-substrate complex. Whereas in competitive inhibitor, inhibitor binds to active site. Here, non-competitive enzyme inhibition, inhibitor molecule binds to a site other than active site. And this binding either to the pre-enzyme or even after enzyme-substrate complex formation. Unlike competitive inhibitors, these non-competitive inhibitors are not structural analogs of that substrate. So their structure is not similar to substrate. So let me explain this non-competitive enzyme inhibition mechanism. We have an enzyme here. Normally, substrate binds to enzyme and forms enzyme-substrate complex. Later, it will give enzyme and product. This is the usual mechanism. You might have noticed in the enzyme, other than active site, this particular enzyme also has got another binding site. Sometimes we call it as allosteric binding site or allosteric site that we will discuss when we discuss enzyme regulation. Here we have an inhibitor, and this inhibitor can bind to pre-enzyme and forms enzyme inhibitor complex. You might have noticed here, this inhibitor molecule is not binding to the active site of an enzyme. It binds to a separate site and forms enzyme inhibitor complex. And as I said earlier, this inhibitor can bind to pre-enzyme or even it can bind to enzyme substrate complex and forming enzyme inhibitor substrate complex. Okay, there are two possibilities here. Either enzyme inhibitor complex or enzyme inhibitor substrate complex. Even enzyme inhibitor complex is formed, then also substrate can bind, but in both the cases, there is no product formation. In other words, there is decrease in the rate of enzyme-catalyzed reaction. Here you can see the inhibitor has same affinity for both the enzyme as well as enzyme-substrate complex. So binding of inhibitor to the enzyme or to the enzyme-substrate complex inactivate this enzyme or decrease the function of enzyme, thereby there will not be any product. And you should remember here, there is no competition between inhibitor and the substrate for the active site. We will study this non-competitive enzyme inhibition mechanism with the help of enzyme kinetics. Normally, enzyme-catalyzed reaction without inhibitors, graph is like this. It is a hyperbolic curve where we can see the maximum velocity, that is zero-order kinetics. If you add an inhibitor to this particular reaction, the graph would be like this. You can see here, there is decrease in the maximum velocity when inhibitor is added. So which type of inhibitor? It is non-competitive inhibitor. When non-competitive inhibitor is added, there is decrease in the maximum velocity. So half max for the normal enzyme-catalyzed reaction is here, whereas half max with the non-competitive inhibitor is here. Now what happens to Km value? You can see the Km value or Michaelis-Menten value with the inhibitor or without inhibitor is same in case of non-competitive enzyme inhibition. Even though there is decrease in maximum velocity or Vmax, but the Km or affinity for the enzyme is same in both with the inhibitor and without non-competitive inhibitors. So in this case, there is no change in the Km value, but there is decrease in the Vmax. We can explain the mechanism of non-competitive enzyme inhibition even by double reciprocal plot or Lineweaver Burk plot, where we are plotting the reciprocal of velocity and reciprocal of substrate concentration. Normally, without inhibitor, the normal enzyme-catalyzed reaction, the graph would be like this. The line which intersects y-axis is 1 by Vmax, and where it touches x-axis is minus 1 by Km. Now, if you add a non-competitive inhibitor, the graph would be like this. Please notice here, there is no change in the Km. You can see here in both the cases, the minus 1 by Km is at the same point. Whereas the line intersects y-axis in two different points. So with the inhibitor, because since this is a reciprocal, there is decrease in the Vmax value or there is a decrease in maximum velocity. We will see some of the uses or clinical significance of this non-competitive inhibitors. So these non-competitive inhibitors are mainly studied in toxicology. Either these non-competitive inhibitors itself are poisons or toxic substances, or sometimes we can make use of this mechanism and we can make a drug to treat poisoning or like an antidote. So both they are poisons or sometimes they can use as a drugs to treat poisoning. Then there are many drugs, even anti-cancer drugs and many drugs which have mechanism as non-competitive inhibitors. We will study some of the examples. Cyanide is a potent, rapidly acting fatal substance. If ingested, it is a very poisonous chemical. It non-competitively inhibits an enzyme called cytochrome C oxidase, which is an important enzyme or complex 4 of electron transport chain or respiratory chain. So the mechanism of action of cyanide poisoning is it inhibits non-competitively the enzyme cytochrome C oxidase. In case of heavy metal poisoning like mercury, cadmium and lead poisoning. So these metal actually they inhibit non-competitively. They will bind to some of the sulfhydryl group of the enzyme. So they are non-competitive inhibitors for the essential or vital enzymes in our body. That is why they lead to poisoning, like lead poisoning, mercury poisoning. Recent studies have demonstrated, researchers have demonstrated, copper and mercury can be used in case of botulinum neurotoxin poisoning. They have demonstrated in rodents where this copper and mercury can inhibit non-competitively light chain protease so that we can treat botulinum neurotoxin poisoning. The recent research have shown that we can use these heavy metals to treat some of the poisonings also. Here I have a table where you can see there are many examples. Here we have a drug etoposide. which can be used to treat cancer. The mechanism of action of this drug, it non-competitively inhibits DNA topoisomerase 2 enzyme, which is an enzyme of DNA replication. Similarly, we can treat Alzheimer's disease, or we can control Alzheimer's disease by a drug called tacrine, which inhibits non-competitively acetylcholine esterase. Trazodone, which is an antidepressant to treat depression, which actually inhibits non-competitively adenosine deaminase. To treat benign enlargement of prostate or benign prostate hyperplasia, we can use this drug TF505, which actually inhibits steroid 5-alpha reductase non-competitively. Doxycycline is an antibiotic which actually inhibits matrix metalloproteinase enzyme. So all these drugs are non-competitive inhibitors. In other words, they have a mechanism of action based on non-competitive inhibitors. Here there is no change in the Km value, but there is decrease in the maximum velocity or Vmax. And non-competitive inhibitors bind to enzyme, a site other than substrate binding site. And non-competitive inhibitors can bind to free enzyme or enzyme-substrate complex, so that it decreases the rate of enzyme-catalyzed reaction or enzyme activity. Thanks for watching.